Students, in the last video lecture, we have already learnt about junction diode in forward bias and reverse bias. Now let us learn some more concepts regarding junction diode in reverse bias. Now this is P-type. P-type is connected to negative of the battery, and this is N-type. N-type is connected to positive of the battery. Obviously, this is in reverse bias. Junction diode is in reverse bias. And when the junction diode is in reverse bias, we already have learned there is a electric field in the direction from positive to negative. Electric field will be in this direction. This is electric field direction, and electrons will be moving in opposite direction. This electron tend to move in opposite direction, hole tend to move in opposite direction, such that electrons and holes will be moving outward from the depletion region. Therefore, width of the depletion region increases. This is width of the depletion region. The width of depletion region increases in reverse bias. Now let me consider that the potential barrier width in reverse bias is 0.3 volt. I am considering that the junction diode, its potential barrier in reverse bias, it is 0.3 volt. Now if the potential difference is zero, like you are applying potential difference which is zero. If you are not applying any potential difference across this junction diode in reverse bias, current in the circuit will become zero. As you are increasing this voltage, this voltage is negative increase. It is, as reverse bias is connected, junction diode is connected in reverse bias, this voltage will be increased negatively. That means 0, minus 10, minus 20, minus 30, minus 40, like that. Well, a voltage will be increased in terms of negative values, which you can see in this graph. 100, 120, so on. And current is chosen on y-axis. Voltage is chosen on x-axis in the graph. And now let us plot graph for the reverse bias for this junction diode. Actually, in order to overcome this potential barrier, you need to provide an energy of 0.3 volt. Like you should provide an electron such that in order to overcome this potential barrier, you need to give some voltage of 0.3 volt. So 0.1 volt, 0.2 volt, 0.3 volt, 0.4 volt, you are going on increasing the voltage negatively. At some particular point, like as you are increasing the voltage, electrons are tending to move in opposite direction. Holes are tending to move in opposite direction from the depletion region, right? Okay. Now, in case of P-type semiconductor, along with holes, there are minority charge carriers. Remember that. In P-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are holes. It does not mean that there will be no minority charge carriers. Minority charge carriers will be there and they are electrons. In N-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are electrons. They will be traveling in this direction. And here, minority charge carriers in N-type semiconductor, they are holes. Now, when you are connecting an external potential difference, what would happen? Minority charge carriers will be moving in the direction of electric field. So this tend to move in this direction. This tend to move in this direction. Likewise, holes tend to move in this direction. Holes here tend to move in this direction. So holes, I'm sorry, this arrow mark is in reverse. Holes tend to move this direction, hole tend to move in this direction because electrons are minority charge carriers in n-type. So when you are connecting junction diode in reverse bias, minority charge carriers in both p-type and n-type semiconductors will be pushed or pulled by electric field. As a result, this electron which is present here, it is forced to cross the barrier, and the hole which is here, it is forced to cross the barrier. Because of that, what is actually happening here? Minority charge carriers are pulled outward from their lattice point, right? So minority charge carriers are pulled from their lattice points, which results in breakage of covalent bonds, which produce sudden increase in electrons and holes in P and N type of junction diode. So as a result, in N type semiconductor, major holes are suddenly increased. In P type semiconductor, electrons are suddenly increased because of breakage of the bond as you are increasing the potential difference. And at that point, suddenly due to breakage of covalent bonds, electrons from P type, holes from N type, they are being moving, they cross the barrier, resulting in sudden increase of the current. So as a result, current in junction diode in reverse bias suddenly increases due to breakdown. This breakdown is called avalanche. This breakdown is called avalanche breakdown. So in avalanche breakdown, what happens is that minority charge carriers are provided for current in the junction diode when it is connected in reverse bias. In reverse bias, avalanche breakdown of junction diode takes place at some high potential which is connected negative bias. At that point, suddenly current increases, and that can be represented in the graph. So if you observe the graph here, you'll be getting, like, initially when you are providing potential difference of minus 10 volt, there will be no current because it may not be sufficient to increase. It may not be sufficient to drag the minority charge carriers from their lattice points. So as a result, current will be zero. But suddenly, if you are providing a voltage of which is little bit greater value, at that time, the covalent bond suddenly break, and which results free electrons and holes in case of p-type and n-type semiconductor. From that point, current increases gradually in reverse bias. Okay, so this is the graph which can be obtained in case of reverse bias due to avalanche breakdown. And the point in the graph which is negative voltage at which current is suddenly increased, it is said to be as breakdown voltage of the junction diode in reverse bias. So that point voltage is said to be as breakdown voltage which is connected in reverse bias. Now you can see that clearly in the animation. So voltage is increasing and as a result, current in the graph suddenly will be increased at some particular point, like at 100, at minus 100 volt. The current in the circuit is suddenly increased in the reverse bias. It is due to breakdown of the junction diode in reverse bias. And clearly, in those, as initially you are providing negative voltage, width of the depletion region is also increasing. Initially, width of the depletion region is 0.3, but it is slightly increased to from 0.3, it is increased to 0.5, and then 0.7, and then 1 volt, and then 2 volt. It goes on increased up to a certain value, say 2 volt. Now, if you are sufficiently providing voltage which is minus 100, at that voltage, the covalent bonds in the p-type and n-type semiconductor will be broken. Covalent bonds break in producing sudden minority charge carriers in p-type and n-type semiconductors. As a result, minority charge carriers will be flowing from p-type to n-type semiconductor, resulting in sudden increase in the current. That is clearly shown in the animation which is in the graph. Students, now let us plot graph for voltage and current in forward bias, when junction diode is connected in forward bias. Here we are taking voltage and here we are taking current. Voltage and current are provided. Voltage is very small, like here in case of forward bias, width of the depletion region is very, very less. As a result, very small amount of voltage can provide sufficient conduction in the forward bias. Therefore, voltage which you are providing will be less, and current here will be greater. Maximum current you can obtain in case of forward bias in the junction diode. So initially, like this is, you are providing a voltage of 0 volt. Therefore, no current will be flowing in the circuit. And if I consider in this forward bias, this potential barrier, let me consider it as 0.3 volt. This is potential barrier, which is 0.3 volt. In order to pass electrons, in order to overcome this potential barrier, electrons should be provided sufficient voltage greater than 0.3 volt. Till that time, there will be no current passing in the circuit. As a result, till some particular value, like till this particular potential, which is 0.3 volt, there will be no current seen. Of course, there is very small value of current. This is diffuse current. The current which is observed here, which is less than, when the potential is less than 0.3 volt, it is said to be diffuse current, and this voltage is said to be as knee voltage. Knee voltage or knee potential. From knee potential, if the voltage still is provided greater, then in such cases, beyond this knee potential, current value increases with respect to voltage, right? This is non-linear graph, does not obey Ohm's law. This does not obey Ohm's law. So remember, current will be greater in case of forward bias. So usually here you will be taking milliampere. And voltage is in between 0 to 1 volt in forward bias. This is the graph which is plotted for forward bias of the junction diode. And the circuit diagram can be seen like this. You are connecting a battery along with your tap key. And current is passing through this circuit. As a result, you will be providing one ammeter. And there will be potential difference measured in this junction diode, and that potential difference is measured by this voltmeter connected parallel to the junction diode. And when you switch on, current flows through this circuit. You can measure current in the circuit. And there can be external resistor also. This external resistor can be R, and some current flowing in the junction diode, which is I, and you are providing voltage V. So I can now simply write current in the circuit. I is equal to delta V divided by net resistance. I is equal to delta V, which is V minus V knee potential, that is the voltage which is provided, divided by resistance. Here is external resistance plus forward resistance of the junction diode. This is equation for current flowing in the junction diode in forward bias. In forward bias, we can say that junction diode is in forward bias if P-type is connected to high potential and N-type is connected to low potential. If P-type is connected to high potential practically and N-type is connected to low potential, then we say that junction diode is in forward bias. And remember that current flow in forward bias in the direction from P-type to N-type. So from P-type to N-type, generally current will be flowing in the circuit in forward bias. Now you can check that in this graph. In this first example, see 5 volt is greater than 2 volt. This is P-type and this is N-type. 5 volt is greater than 2 volt. That is the reason why current will be flowing from high potential to low potential. This is the example of forward bias. Likewise, in B example, minus 3 volt is greater than minus 5 volt. Minus 3 value is greater than minus 5 volt. Therefore, current will be flowing from P-type to N-type. This is also in forward bias. And coming to number C, this is 0 volt and this is minus 5 volt. Ground is said to be 0 voltage. 0 voltage is greater than minus 5 volt. That is the reason why current will be flowing from ground to minus 5 volt. Therefore, this is in forward bias. Next, 2 voltage and this is connected to ground. Ground potential is 0. Therefore, 2 is greater than ground potential, which is 0. Therefore, current will be flowing from 2 to 0. Therefore, this junction diode is connected in forward bias. These all are examples of junction diode which are connected in forward bias. We say that junction diode is connected in reverse bias. Junction diode is said to be connected in reverse bias if P-type is connected to lower potential and N-type is connected to higher potential. So if N-type is connected to high potential and P-type is connected to low potential, we say that it is reverse bias. In reverse bias, current in the circuit will be equal to 0. So in the reverse bias, junction diode act as switch off condition. So before breakdown, there will be no current in the circuit. And usually when we are providing negative voltage for the reverse bias in the circuits, that voltage will not be greater than breakdown voltage. If you are using a junction diode in the circuit, in any problem, if you get junction diode in reverse bias, along that path, there will be no current. Simply you should take it as I equal to 0. Right? Now let us see these examples. From these examples, you can make it clear. These all junction diodes are connected in reverse bias. See, this is 2 volt and it is 5 volt. 5 volt is high potential. High potential is connected to negative. 2 volt is low potential and it is connected to p-type. Therefore, current cannot flow in this direction. Therefore, it is said to be reverse bias. Next, this is minus 5 volt. This is minus 3 volt. It is high potential. It is low potential. N-type connected to high potential. Current cannot flow in this junction diode. Similarly, this is ground, which is 0, and this is 2 volt. 2 volt is high potential. 0 is low potential. Current cannot flow through this. It is N-type and it is p-type. This is reverse bias circuit. Next, it is 0 and this is minus 5 volt. Minus 5 volt is low potential. 0 is high potential. Therefore, current cannot flow from N-type to p-type. Current in the circuit will be taken to 0. This is reverse bias junction diode. This is the way you can identify junction diode in reverse bias. Students, I already told you, in case of forward bias, a junction diode is connected in forward bias. This is p-type and this is n-type. P-type is connected to positive, n-type is connected to negative. This is junction diode connected in forward bias. External resistance is capital R. Current flowing in the circuit is I. Battery provided is E. And this junction diode will have some knee potential. I consider this as VB, where VB is said to be knee potential or barrier potential. Net current in the circuit can be written as E minus VB, where E is battery potential. And this is junction diode. I can now simply write I passing in the circuit is equal to voltage divided by net resistance. So I is equal to net voltage is battery potential minus barrier potential divided by net resistance is external resistance of the circuit plus forward resistance. E is equal to battery voltage. And VB is equal to barrier potential. R is equal to external resistance, which is in the circuit. And RF is equal to forward resistance of the junction diode. Forward resistance, or you can even call it as dynamic resistance of the junction diode. Usually it will be in forward bias connected. Students, we already have plotted graphs for junction diode in forward bias and reverse bias. In case of forward bias, you will be getting graph for plus V and plus I. Whereas in reverse bias, you will be getting graph for minus V and minus I. Therefore, junction diode which is provided, this is in forward bias. And this is in reverse bias. In reverse bias, you are providing voltage where junction diode is connected in reverse bias in such a way. This is high potential and this is low potential. Current will be going from high potential to low potential, but in this case, it's not possible till breakdown voltage. Whereas in forward bias, up to knee potential, there will be very small value of current in the circuit. And this current, which is generated here, it is said to be diffuse current in forward bias, right? This current is diffuse current. Diffuse current is because when P and N type, both are coming like when you are preparing a junction diode which is P and N combination, at the junction by default some of the electrons will be recombined with the holes of N, holes of P type. Because of that there is very small current produced in the circuit, which is because of recombination of holes and electrons in the region, depletion region. That is the reason why small diffuse currents are being observed in the forward bias, even though the voltage which you are providing is less than knee voltage. Once if the voltage is greater than knee voltage, the current will be increased to maximum value. Slowly in forward bias, current goes on increases because of majority charge carriers. So remember that this current is because of majority charge carriers. So in forward bias, current is because of majority charge carriers. But whereas in case of reverse bias, in reverse bias, what happens is that till voltage is less than breakdown voltage, there will be no current in the circuit. So remember that in forward bias, V is less than VB, I is nearly equal to zero. V greater than VB, I is greater than zero. And this is because of majority charge carriers. Whereas in case of reverse bias, voltage, if the applied voltage is less than breakdown voltage, then current in the circuit will be equal to zero. And if the applied voltage is greater than breakdown voltage, current suddenly increases, and this current sudden increase is because of breaking of covalent bonds in P and N type. And here current is due to minority charge carrier breakage. It is because of minority charge carriers breakdown, there will be current flowing in this reverse bias circuit.